Good morning. Welcome to the Heart and Soul Programs of India Virtual Life Ministry. We thank God for the month of July as we are living in the hands of God as the climate change situation is very favorable to us. The schools opened and all education institutions also started their teaching programs and many good things are happening in and around this world now. Praise God for this morning as we are getting one more chance to listen and to discuss the Word of God. So we have to bow before God and ask God for giving us the wisdom. Let's pray. Father, we love you this moment, in this morning, and this is a new day for us. Thank you, Lord, for equipping us to realize your presence and experience you more, Father. And we pray for the subject which you are going to give us this morning for discussion. Help us to fully focus on you. Thank you for keeping in this way, guiding in this way. In Jesus' name we pray in this moment. Amen. Amen. India Bridget Life is always focusing on God and His family. So we are indebted to God for giving such an enlightenment to advise families and to help families and assist families to stand as a God's unity in this world. God can directly claim that this family is mine. God put the name for all these families that's mentioned in Ephesians. So God called everybody by their name because He knows everybody personally. God calls every family in their family name as God knows them. Where are they born and where are they from? So these are the real realization for us. We were continuing one topic like that. How much God is loving each one of us, that much God is interested to discipline us. How can we know the discipline of the Lord? For any discipline in this world, we know that there must be some suffering from both sides. Both sides, who is a disciple, and who is a discipline. So both sides we have to expect some suffering. So Bible talks about a well meaning of this topic, discipline. In Hebrews chapter 12 verses 7 to 11 says, if you endure chastening, God deals with you as with sons. For what a son is there whom the father does not chasten? The 12 verse 7, he says like that. But if you are with the chastening of which all have become partakers, then you are illegitimate and not sons. Furthermore, we have had human fathers who corrected us, and we paid them respect. Shall we not much more readily be in subjecting to the Father of the Spirit and live? For they indeed a few days chastening us, and seems best to them, and he for our profit, that we may be partakers of his holiness. How? No chastening seems to be joyful for the present, but painful. Nevertheless, afterwards it yields to the peaceful fruit of the righteousness to those who have been trained by it. These are an elaborated definition of meaning of this persuasion and suffering and discipline. All seems to be like a same meaning, but we have to understand that we have to go through many kinds of hardship for getting more discipline from the Lord. How much you are disciplined, that much you will be profitable to the kingdom of God. So when we read Acts chapter 22, it's mentioned that we must go through many hardship to enter the kingdom of God. It's not easy to enter the kingdom of God by a simple walk. Only Hebrews says that it is a human race. It's equal to a human race. A race must have a discipline. So we have discussed this last week that Shiny Wilson run the race. But for a few seconds, she sidetracked. She was called disqualified. It's our experience of our Indian sports history. Therefore, we need to run the race with a prescribed or a disciplined format. For each format, we need have a discipline. So in this discipline, what God is expecting us that we have to accept the discipline, or we can reject the discipline. Suppose if we accept the discipline, what will happen? So we are fully cooperating with God. We are fully cooperating with ourselves. We are totally surrender ourselves to the disciplined will of God. So we may have a future expectation. This suffering will not long for many years, many months. It has a stipulated time. After that, we may be promoted to higher positions. We may be in charge with some responsibility. Therefore, this discipline is a very good opportunity for a believer to undergo this kind of suffering. That's what the Word of God is talking about. So if we look on the life of Moses, that is written in the chapter 11, it says about something about verses chapter 11 verses 24 onwards. By faith Moses, when he became of age, refused to be called as the son of Pharaoh's daughter. Pharaoh's daughter was equal to the king of that country, and he rejected to be called as a son of Pharaoh's daughter. He may be higher of Pharaoh in the future. But instead of that, choosing rather to suffer afflictions with the people of God than to enjoy the passing of pleasures of sin. So this is Moses, and his discipline was very clear. He can be known as a daughter of Pharaoh and enjoy the pleasures of the world. That is what every young man in this world is looking for, the pleasures of the world. Without any expense spending, without much sacrifice, everything come to the door for Moses. His position was a respectable position. Everything is before his eyes. Only a matter of word he should command. Let it come means that it will come, because it's the kingly authority there. He is the part of kingly family. But when he was looking at the future of this life, he knows the pleasure of sin is contagious. Sin is like a cancer. It is a most dangerous thing which will happen to the life of a believer. So therefore, he decided to leave the position of Pharaoh's daughter. Rather than that, he suffer, ready to suffer the afflictions with the people of God. People of God is moving, going with a definite God. They were looking with a definite example in their life. Their Savior and their Lord suffered. Therefore, they know the people of God is moving with a destination. Here Moses saw that these people were suffering. It is also part of discipline for Hebrew people. So he looks and he thought, sometimes this may end. After that, they will get a huge reward that is everlasting. If I spend time with the Pharaoh, if I be known as a Pharaoh's son, what will going to happen to me? I am living with the unrealistic situations. This situation is unrealistic, not real. So he is enjoying somebody's position. One day it will reveal and he will be thrown out of his throne. So he evaluated these situations and he was ready to choose the afflictions with the people of God. They were considered as slaves there and they lived in Egypt for long years, 430 years as slaves. The beginning was good for them with the Joseph period. After that, they were considered as slaves. So now the condition, he saw this condition, he knows that God now is not silent. God is going to deal with the problems of Hebrews. Moses sensed the reality of the time. Moses sensed the reality of the incident. He knows that history is there, but God is going to change his history of these people. So dear ones, you don't feel worry in your life. You don't be upset in your life. Because even though it has happened for the last several centuries, but your destination is going to change. You are no longer going to stay in Egypt. You are not going to live in the slavery. You are going to be delivered by a Savior immediately. So this is what Moses' life has explained to us. But God is planned to, he was planned to discipline Moses through trials and testings and temptations. And how did he overcome this temptation of Pharaoh's palace? Because by looking at the afflictions and sufferings of the people of God. So discipline actually giving us another area of life that we have to be the partakers of his righteousness and holiness. So without suffering, no one can expect holiness. For holiness and for a purity, we need to go to various kinds of sufferings. Even we are getting gold. So how many refining process has been already done to get a pure gold? Even for iron also, even each metal has to go with a lot of kind of purification process. Even I heard about the locker. The locker heated many times in the fire. The locker. That metal was fired for purity for many times. Four times rather than compared to other kinds of ironing. Iron purposes, metals. And also it will put, they will throw this one from top to the bottom. It can break, but it will not break. The stuff is so solid, the stuff is so pure, and the stuff is so powerful. So likewise, God need you to undergo kind of situations. Don't complain to God about your problem. That's what the Word of God says in Psalm 100 and verse 67 and 71 says, it was good to me to be afflicted so that I might learn your decrees. I might learn your decrees. So Psalmist says, it was good to me to be afflicted. Some people permitted them to be afflicted. Like Jesus also permitted, yes, I have no problem. He never complained about the problems, the persecutions. Why? Jesus was a perfect person. Therefore, he will not shake in his character, his basic qualities. So as we are looking at the discipline, let us not be discouraged by the discipline of the Lord, because he will never cast out us. He wants us more valuable for equipping God's service. So you are in home sometimes, you are in work sometimes, you are in some places. Once upon a time, I saw a person who came to home at midday. While I also visited him that time, he was unable to give a peaceful word. He is burning inside. He is quarreling with his family. He is making too much heavy voices. Then I asked him, pious way, I asked him, so why you are making such a huge noise? He said that I have a lot of conflicts with my co-workers in my company. He was working as a works manager. He was in charge of a plan. He has to take care of many things. And he asked people to do something. They disobeyed this man. And finally, in the evening, when we come out with the output of the company, he said that he was a failure. That makes him upset. That makes him worry. That makes him to shame before his authority. He was broken. One day it was too heavy for him. He came back to home and shared with the wife. I cannot tolerate. I cannot move with the people because they are not genuine. They are all inferior people. They are not at a perfect in the job. I am having exhaust feeling. I cannot do anything with them. I asked him for details, and he said that it started many years before. Still, I am in a peak stage. I said that, sir, you relax. There is a way for you to come out. Then when we evaluated, he is unable to match with the situation because he cannot change a group of men. He cannot change the pattern which is followed by the company. So all their intention was to take benefit out of company, not giving anything to company. They are least concerned about the company. So finally, better to get out from the company immediately. I advised him that, what is your quality? What is your other kinds of talent? He said, I am a musician. I can teach music. Then I advised him, why don't you just start your own music school? Though you are getting a handsome salary from this plant, but you are not living. You are always burning. Your enjoyment has taken away. You are making such a havoc situation your family members. So your present job is affecting you, not only you, but it is affecting even every member of your family, including your mother. So what's the best decision for you? You have to take a good decision. Are you continuing with the same situation? Because in no way you can change the situation of the company. So that's a union. They are very strong. They have some evil practices that a single man cannot change it. So finally he decided to spend some time with God. We strongly advise him to spend time with God. Then after that, for strengthening your mind, take a decision. Which one is good? Whether to continue or whether to discontinue this work. If you discontinue, definitely you may have suffering. You will not get a handsome salary. So my advice for you is to start a school. Maybe in many years you may suffer. You will not get enough students in the first few years. So that time you have to work out. But only thing we can offer you is that peace. Otherwise, every day you have an exhaustive situation in your company. There's no working situation for you. Finally, that person accepted. And he spent time with God. One day he called me and said that my mind is so strong now. I have decided to resign from my job. Then another day he called me and shared with me that the proposal you gave me was to start a music school. So I am going to start a music school. I'm starting it into my home situation. He started a music class in his home. First time only two people came. Then finally people added more. Now he's having a handsome number of people in his school. He shifted that school into a big place. Now the family is rejoicing in the salvation of God. Now he is also bearing the immense happiness in his heart because he is a highly talented musician. His ability is recognized. He got many approvals. And you cannot imagine his past life and his personal life. Why? Because he allowed himself to undergo a suffering, a necessary suffering. That was, working with the company was unnecessary suffering. Nothing is to go into gain from that. Because to live with the sinners is not an easy task. To live with the people, those who are not disciplined, is not at all a peaceful atmosphere for a person. So therefore, everybody needs a such kind of discipline that comes through the word suffering. Moses was disciplined. That's what he knows. To live with this sinful gang in the king's palace, they are always looking the pleasure. Immoral things are happening. Adultery will happen. So they will run in behind God and goddesses. So no way to be secure a real peace from this situation. Though it was a king's palace, it was surrounded with all the sinful nature. Killing, murder, many things. So better to move to the land where the king, where the God's children, they were all having affliction. Not enough food, not enough situations, not enough place to stay over, not enough dresses. And in between, there are attacks, persecution, torture, all sorts of things. But that is temporary. That is temporary. One day, God will deal with suffering. So I am with that person. That was Moses. Moses' decision, that's what it says about. In Hebrews chapter 11, verse 26 says, Esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt, for he looked to a reward. Look on the race and the final destination of the race. They cannot reach the destination. They will be forsaken on the way. But to live with the God's people, they have a destination. And the power between him, the power behind him, the power before him, were able to lead these people to reach out their destination. So Moses' decision was a fantastic decision. Because he is disciplined by God. God sent him to the wilderness for 40 years. First 40 years he was with the palaces, with the pleasures, with the enjoyment. But next 40 years God sent him to the wilderness and in the bushes and to leave us a shepherd, lot of sheep, flocks. He was known as a shepherd Moses. Never knew that this is the way God is disciplining him. One day, the God called Moses. Moses, move to the Egyptians and give a leadership to your people. I want to save my people from the hands of the Pharaoh. That time only Moses realized that all these sufferings because for a better future. So God disciplines some of you and some of us. There is a definite plan for God to save many of our people to come into the front line of the society. God can change it. Believe in God. So the words God's word says that when we are disciplined, we must understand that in Isaiah chapter 35, verse 3 says, therefore strengthen your feeble arms and weak knees. Strengthen your feeble arms and weak knees. So when you are working with the hands, when you are praying and kneeling before God, nothing can hinder you. Nothing can defeat you. Because your suffering will be going to answer. Heaven will reward you. This is the word of God. This is the word of God is speaking by the Holy Spirit. So no sufferings will not be going to be awarded. God is going to honor that kinds of situations. So when we look on the word, why he is disciplining us means we may share his holiness. When we are getting more purity, we'll have more carrots, more grade. In purity, there is more grade. Different kinds of grades are there. Like a gold, pure gold. 18 carat is not a pure. 20 carat, not a pure gold. 22 carat, not a pure gold. 24 carats, that also has 916 purity. So our aim is not on 916 clarity, but it is 100%. Our discipline God is putting for us to prove that we may be sharing the glory with God. We are also qualified with God, qualified for God. So therefore church, therefore the group of people for God, a family, you should not worry. Your trials and your testings and your temptation is going to be honored by God if you go properly. So the men of faith, one day your name also will be going to enlisted there, because you are also standing and preserving the faith in your Master, Lord Jesus. May the good God bless you with all these words. Thank you so much for listening today's Heart and Soul program. May God bless you. Thank you.